The last thing we want to cover in this module is the management interfaces for Azure SQL. Now, what we mean by that is that there are different ways for you to interact with Azure SQL. One of those ways is the Azure portal. And what you're seeing here is the Azure SQL unified experience, where we've kind of tried to bring that what to use when you've seen throughout previous videos into the portal itself.
You know, we want to make sure you have the tools you need. So all of you probably watching this are used to SQL Server Management Studio, and SQL Server Management Studio is completely compatible with Azure SQL Database and Managed Instance. In fact, Azure Management Studio understands it's talking to an Azure SQL Database and provides only the options you need. In addition, you've probably seen our new tool called Azure Data Studio. It's cross-platform and open source, fully compatible to work with both Azure SQL Database and Managed Instance, providing all the same functionality you would get if you're using a SQL Server. And finally, many of you like me are command line driven, and all of our tools and interfaces that you're going to use are going to be supported across any client operating system you need. Of course, the T-SQL language you're going to use all the time, but you're going to see in this series several different T-SQL differences from a management interface, like Alter Database, for example, that make sense just for Azure SQL. In addition, PowerShell and Azure CLI are available to you for many different management operations, and the core of actually talking to Azure, both across the Azure ecosystem and Azure SQL Database and Managed Instance, is a REST API. So you can even go at the REST level to do various management operations for Azure SQL. And then finally, for those of you who are command line driven, know SQL Command and BCP, these tools are very compatible to use on your client or even an Azure virtual machine to talk to Azure SQL. So you've seen your choices for management interfaces. You got the portal, which is new to you maybe, but it's going to give you a lot of different options to do many different things to manage Azure SQL. You've got the familiar tool of Management Studio, our new Azure Data Studio, lots of command line choices, the T-SQL language. We think we've given you just about everything you need to manage Azure SQL resources. See you on the next video.